Go back to Mississippi. Go back to Alabama. Go back to South Carolina. Go back to Georgia. Go back to Louisiana. Go back to the slums and ghettos of our northern cities. Knowing that somehow this situation can and will be changed. Let us not wallow in the valley of despair. I say to you today, my friend.
And so, even though we have to face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream deeply rooted in the American dream.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. And we hold these truths to be self-evident, and all men are created equal.
I have a dream that one day on the Red Hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood.
I have a dream that one day even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will one day be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice.
I have a dream that one day my four little children will live in a nation that they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day down in Alabama, with its religious receipts, with its governor having lips dripping with words of interposition and nullification.
One day, right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day all the valleys shall be exalted, and the hills and mountains will be made low, and the rough places to be made plain, and the crooked places to be made straight. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together.
This is our hope. And this is the faith that I go back to the South with. And with this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope.
With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day.
And this will be the day when all of God's children will sing with new meaning, "My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing, land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside let freedom ring."
And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true. So let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom ring from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania.
Freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado. Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slopes of California. But not only that, let freedom ring from Stone Mountain of Georgia.
Let freedom ring from every lookout mountain of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi.
And when this happens, we allow freedom to ring. Ring to every village and every hamlet, to every state and every city, and speed up the day with all God's children.
Black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing out the words of the old Negro spiritual.
Sometimes I live under the moon. I thank God I'm breathing. And I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason.
Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me.